vice versa. This aisle is for those who come in and can come straight to the altar to repent of their sin, to call on God to help them, to petition God for their life, for their family life, for their friends life. It is not a division to divide the church.
Amen.
No way anybody sitting in church should be sitting on the other side of this aisle because they don't like somebody on the other side.
All right.
Syria, and they want some land that Judah owned. So now they have gone to their brother to get them to fight with them against their brother, Judah. Now, how are you going to call me and tell me to come on, let me fight against your brother? Come on, all right, Tony, so you come on my side. We just not going to like Tony together. Yeah. No, that's my brother. And you don't like him, then you got a problem. Yeah. Because I'm standing by my brother. That is my little brother. And I'm not going to go against him. And that's how we should be in Christ Jesus. Somebody say, you know, Sister Brenda always doing it, always saying that. Why she think that? You know what I'm saying? You know what? If you don't like it, you don't have to deal with it. But she is this kind of person. She is that kind of person. Yeah, she might do some things you don't like. But at least I know, being in church with her, she's striving to do what God has called her to do. We need to stand up one for another. When I see God is strong, and he connects me with somebody just as strong to help me in my infirmity. When we're weak, we're supposed to help those. When we're strong, we're supposed to help those that are weak. That means we don't tear them down, but we build them up.
Amen.
Now, girl, she go to church every day, but she ain't that. Oh, she ain't a slave. She ain't a prayer Christian you think she is. She ain't that thing. Girl, you ought to see her home. Y'all, no. Look, she made some mistakes. Or he might do some things that he shouldn't do, but his heart is contented toward God. See, we judge people on church religion. We judge people on a fleshy stuff instead of their heart. That's why everybody ought to glorify to the fact that God judges a man on his heart. He looks on the inside and not on the outside. Because my hairstyle today, you might like, but tomorrow you might be talking about, like, what did she think she was doing with that wig on looking like that? So God don't look, that's how we can get past seeing what God wants us to see for looking at gifts and judging on gifts. But God, when standing there, God is judging our heart. So he don't give it to me. This might look awful. This might be the bad color. This might not fit right. But God said a heart. Is toward me. So now we got to start working on people's flesh and start dealing with their hearts. We got to put words of God in their hearts.
Amen.
We got to teach them how to let their heart groan and ache for Jesus by giving them words, telling them what God likes, not telling them what they need to stop doing, not telling them what they need to stop going. Because you put love in a person's heart. If I love you, you can do something wrong with me and I will forgive you. But if I have no love for you and you do something wrong to me, then there might be some consequences. So when we have the love of God in our heart, one for another, then we can forgive some things. We can look over some things. And that's how it is in the world. We have to have love for those people. When they come in here begging and all that, we can't just treat them any kind of way. We got to talk to them respectfully, because that's how we want to be taught. They come in here, baby, no, this, I don't have any money, but what I do have, remember Paul? I mean, Peter and Ellie said, silver gold I have none, but that I do have, they may not want to hear, but you can offer it to them.
Amen.
You know, that is up to them if they don't want to hear it. Right. But you can't feed money into an empty well, because you get no outcome. But if you feed the word of God, then you might see some flourish and buzz begin to grow. Because the more you give them the word of God, don't worry about it sinking in. Because if you do the work, if you do the evangelizing, you not the work, but you evangelize. You talk to people. God does the work by letting the blood in their heart. Yes. See, they're not trying to convince them. It's all trying to teach them. Yes. And God will do the rest. So now, then, if you read the book of Isaiah, you'll think these people never knew God. Mm-hmm. But then again, you look at some of our lives now outside of God, outside of the church.
Amen.
You would think we never knew God.
Amen.
You know, we need to see your heart and not see our heart. So I'm not judging, I'm just telling you. Because there's some things that you're like, what? You said she? That's why people tell a long time, and she's supposed to be a Christian, because they're judging our actions. They're judging us and not our hearts. So he warned the people, and it's full of woe is, because they have done some unseen things. You know, like they bring it, and this is what I mean by church religion. They go into worship.